it's already late, so I'm going to do a very short introduction of myself. So I'm Dr. Nipa Choksi, and I work as a narrative practitioner and as a life purpose coach. So today we're here to talk about emotional well-being, especially given the pandemic times when a lot of things have gone wrong and a lot of people have suffered a lot mentally, emotionally, health-wise, in a lot of different ways. So all the more this topic has become very important today. So would anybody want from the audience want to talk and let me know what do y'all understand by emotional well-being? You know, when we talk of emotional well-being, what is it that comes to your mind? Would anybody want to go with that?
For me, when you have balanced emotions for everything.
Yeah. So can you be a little louder? I'm unable to hear.
Am I audible? Okay. Now am I audible?
Yes, yes. This is better.
For me, the emotional well-being when you have balanced emotions.
Okay. Okay. Anybody else wants to try that? Anyone else? Shweta, Komal, do any of y'all want to try? Like, what do you understand by emotional well-being?
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm Sanjay Gupta. Just wanted to know that, what I feel is that emotional well-being, especially during the COVID times, would mean how to keep your head cool while everything around you is boiling.
Absolutely. And why do you think is emotional well-being important? Why has it was always important, but it's especially come to the surface in these COVID times. So can anybody let me know why do you all feel emotional well-being is important?
Yeah, because everything that we had up to now has gone, say, topsy-turvy. Mm. I mean, we had a routine in which we used to go to office and office was office and home was home.
Right.
Now with work from home, you know, everything has gone, say, topsy-turvy. Home has become office and office is now, even those guys are finishing the commercial space for rent. We don't know when we'll go back.
Right.
So, and, you know, staying at home with everyone around for 24 hours, you know, it does develop family fatigue.
Right.
So with all these things, there's a very great need for emotional well-being, I guess.
Absolutely, you know. So that's why this topic has become so much more important today. So basically what happens in a lot of ways, our mind works in a particular way. It is used to a set system of working. And suddenly when that gets disturbed, the whole world turns topsy-turvy for us. So what are the basic, when we talk of emotions, you know, what are the basic elements that go into emotions? So we first begin with identifying our own emotions, which is more important than anything else. Is to, you know, in a particular situation, how is that I will react? Or what is it that I will be doing, you know, that I probably may not be doing? As we step out in the environment, there are always a lot of triggers sitting in that environment. So how are we going to manage those triggers? But before we manage the triggers, it becomes important for us to identify what those triggers are. It could be something as little as, you know, maybe you're in a classroom or, you know, you're working somewhere and maybe your boss gives attention to somebody else more than you, or you get reprimanded for your work. Or anything of that sort can work as a trigger. Something as little as, you know, maybe when you're commuting, maybe in, you know, packed cities and public transport and somebody else has knocked your seat or somebody's rubbed you the wrong way. So the idea is first to identify where our emotions are, where my emotions as an individual stand. What is my level of tolerance? What is my level of patience? Am I getting irritated by every little thing that comes my, you know, that kind of rubs me the wrong way? Or is it that... anything that anybody else does bothers me more than what I am supposed to do. So once we identify these triggers with ourselves, that's when we make peace with ourselves. So we can tell ourselves, okay, you know, the slightest push from somebody makes me angry. The slightest remark, an unpleasant remark towards me upsets me, makes, you know, takes off my day, takes off my moments from my day. So once we are in sync with that, then what is the next step that we do is we learn to manage these emotions, which we call as self-regulation. So in self-regulation, what happens is we have to adapt and move to techniques which will not let us react to emotions in a strong way. See, there's nothing right or wrong with emotions. They are all emotions and they all work in their own way. It's our ability to manage the emotions. So what happens in certain stressful situations, we let the emotions overtake us and manage us instead of us managing them. So once we get into the mode of self-regulation, our mind stays in place, our mind stays in check, which allows us to act in a way which is socially acceptable and which is conducive to our development. Each time we act in a way which is not acceptable, or we become very impulsive, we end up doing things which create hurdles for us rather than clear the hurdles for us. So what we need to learn is ways of self-regulating ourselves. So that could be something as little as, you know, in a moment, once I've identified, okay, these are unpleasant situations for me, instead of just blurting out something or instead of just getting into a wrong action, what can be done is, you know, we take a step back and we do, you know, the most common thing is, you know, you give yourself a little timeout. That timeout can vary from individual to individual. It could vary from maybe 5 counts to 10 counts or a few minutes to anything that, you know, we need to figure out with time with each of ourselves as to what is it in those timeouts that, you know, which, what is the particular timeout that will work for us or that will help us in those situations. The next thing, once we have understood the art of self-regulation, what we need to do is motivate ourselves to understand and not give in to an impulse which is going to create or add to the hurdle sitting out there. So once we have done that, once we have crossed the, once we have learned to identify the triggers, we have learned to self-regulate, self-motivation becomes a lot easier because we are able to keep charge of ourselves, motivate ourselves to take charge, take control, which are precisely the qualities which help us lead from the front. So once we have crossed all of these hurdles, instead of creating new hurdles, when we self-motivate ourselves to think and to act, we are actually clearing the path for ourselves. In return, what happens in social setups, people start looking up to you in a, with a different eye, with a different perspective, because you notably stand out as somebody who is able to take control of yourself and able to manage situations in a peaceful and a guarded way. So that not only elevates your personal self-esteem, but also gives you a certain hold in the society where you belong to. So you, people start looking at you as a peacemaker, as a conflict resolver, which are very important stance as you grow out, you know, and as you move ahead from you. Once all these things are done, you motivate, you figured out your triggers, you've learned to self-regulate, you've learned to motivate yourself, you can maximize your potential from it. You can do exactly what you plan to do, what you wish, in a lot more peaceful and a lot more better way. So the output of everything that you wish to do turns out to be way better. It also leads to an increased level of empathy in oneself, because you put yourself in a position where the way you identify yourself, automatically with time you start identifying other people. You start putting yourself in the shoes of other people, and you start figuring out as to what is it that is causing them to react or respond or behave in a particular way. And it makes it a lot more easier for you to step out, go out over there, help them tide over those situations. So in a lot of ways, once you are emotionally strong, you're emotionally fit, you know, you will see yourself managing not just yourself, but also the environment and the space around you in which you are present. There are a lot of ways, a lot of people, despite understanding the triggers, fail to reach the level of self-regulation, or if they have reached self-regulation, they fail to reach the stage of self-motivation, and obviously then all things fall apart from there. So there are different tactics, different strategies that work very well once you start identifying the triggers. But yes, identifying the triggers becomes the baseline, which is, I think, in a direction which everybody needs to put in efforts. If I know I am very short-tempered, I have to understand what is it that pushes me so easily, takes over me so easily that I lose my cool so easily, and I go out and do or say things which are unpleasant for everyone around. And of course, in the bargain, things do get more difficult for me, because we all live in a social setup where we need to maintain the decorum of the place. Whether we like it or no, there is always a certain way to behave, a certain way to react, a certain way to do things. Not necessarily to please everybody, but to keep the peace moving. And more so, it helps our individual development and progress. Even if I have to challenge a particular person or an authority, or for any other reason, if I feel I'm in conflict and I need to bring it up, there is a way of bringing it up. And once you learn that, once you are in sync with your own self, you will see that you will be able to bring out all these things a lot more better, a lot more positively for yourself. So the different ways in which, you know, you can help yourself cope and develop this entire process, the best way would be stimulation of your five senses. Scientifically, it has been proved that increase in gadget time, increase in, you know, the way the lifestyles have been moving off late, we have kind of cut off from our senses. The sensory stimulation which is required is not happening to that extent. It's not happening to the level at which it should be happening. So all our senses are dying down, if you see, a lot with time, more so because, of course, more so in the lockdown, because we've stayed stuck to devices for very, 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 very long. And most of our time is moved in enclosed places. But of course, as and when time permits, it does become important to stimulate our senses. The five senses that we all know, which become very important, are your senses of touch, smell, taste, vision, and hearing. So there are different ways in which we can do this. You know, even if you Google, you know, the ways to stimulate your senses to help you stay calm, you'll find plenty of things. Suppose you want to use touch. And also for this, it becomes important to find out what suits each one the most. For somebody, it may be the tactile, the touch, which, you know, is very soothing, very calming. For somebody, it may be the auditory, which is very soothing. For someone else, it may be visual. For someone, it may be the flavors, the food flavors, or for somebody else, it may be the different aromas. So it becomes important to also identify what works for me, because what works for me may not work for someone else. And that obviously comes with experience over a period of time, once you have experimented a couple of ways with yourself. But just to mention a few modes which you can, you suppose you understand that, okay, you are an auditory person, and you know, anything that's soothing to your ears helps you calm down. There are lots of different kinds of soothing musics you can listen to. The chirping of the birds, which also has a very, very, very positive and a calming effect. The sound of the waves. While all of this is available online, because sometimes you cannot directly go out and have access to all these modalities, as far as possible, try and see, you know, even if stepping down and you can pick up the sound of the birds, if nothing else, or, you know, the sound of the leaves brushing against each other, or whatever natural nature sounds, they work for auditory people. For the visuals, again, it's the motion, the waves. I mean, if you're around a beach place, and if you have access to the sea, of course, visualizing the waves. Lot of different things, which I guess it's important for each one to figure out in their own way what works. For those for whom it's the smells, you can try out the different aroma oils which work. Also the spices that we have at home, you know, the cinnamons, the cloves, they have a certain smell. The coffee beans have a smell which also works very well for a lot of people. So again, like I said, you know, we need to figure out for ourselves what is it that will work for us. It always helps to go out and seek help from people around us. If we are in a confused state, we are not able to figure out where, at what point we are getting stuck in our emotional regulation. So you can always have maybe your family or your friends, or you can always maintain a personal diary, making a note of the instances each time, you know, a trigger has managed to get the better of you. Once that happens, once you realize that this particular thing acts as a trigger, and this is what I, these are the frequencies with which it is attacking me, you will be able to understand and start regulating yourself there. So maintaining it somewhere in a written format, you know, as a diary, where you can identify the pattern, the frequency, will definitely help you get, go notches higher and help you deal with it better. So is there anything anybody wants to ask, or any confusion, any doubt on how to get to the better of this? Anybody has any, because I'm really sorry, you know, for my system being crashed last minute, and I did not have a backup of my presentation. So that's what has caused this problem today. But is there anything else anybody wants to ask, talk? Yeah, anyone has any questions? So what I will do is, once I get my presentation, maybe I can just share the PPT, or what I can also do is we can reschedule it.